Hey guys, so I want to take a look today at MSR Dragonfly. Starting to cool off, we got fall weather coming, and I'll be hopefully getting outside more. And I want to show you like basically the annual maintenance that I do to the stove. Just kind of getting everything ready, making sure we're safe and everything's lubed up and you know the way it's supposed to be. I always keep the directions with me. Mainly because if I have to do something in the field, if I'm having a problem, I have, detailed diagrams of what's what and directions on how to do things. And, you know, so there's really no second guessing. I don't have to wonder if I'm doing it the right way or not. Or if, you know, maybe someone at camp will do it for you and you don't feel like sitting there and explaining it to them. You say, hey, the directions are in the bag and they can just get on it. So this came with my kit. I did buy this used. I did not buy it new, so if there's something, if I'm missing something, I would not know it. Okay, so we got the tool, the lube. This is for cleaning the jets. There's little wires there, one on each end. You can see it in the light. And then we have our jet. I don't know why this is in there, but the stove does have two jets. They are labeled with letters, and then the O-rings. This little white ball is actually the filter for the fuel line. So keep all that handy. I'm gonna start with the actual stove itself. Okay, so there are a few gaskets that we wanna make sure are oiled up. The first one I'm gonna do is gonna be, cut myself, make sure I'm not bleeding. Okay, the first one I'm gonna do is right here. Okay, so that is, it's pretty snug. Now, if you're doing this at home, you're going to be really tempted to just use any old tool that you have laying around. For example, it would be really easy for me to just use these to perform the loosening of the bolts and tightening of the bolts. But you really want to refrain from that, okay? And I'll explain to you why. Let's see here. That's pretty good and black. There's a little needle there on the tip. So right down here, right here is our two rings. You can get a good look at that. And then the oil that they supply, you're gonna want to go ahead and just apply a very little bit. Now I actually did this all an hour ago, and then I got the idea to do the video, so I'm just gonna walk through the steps. I really don't need to be putting anything on here, but one little drop. Earlier I just put two drops, but that one drop, I mean, you get it on there, you move it around a little bit, it goes a long way. So when taking out and inserting it, there's actually two threaded sections here, okay? This one here is really the only one that you think of because it's what you can see, but you actually want to thread the inside first. I'm just going to go to it stops. Okay, so it stopped. So now the valve is closed. And this is still pretty good and loose. So I'm just going to hand tighten it. Okay, and now I'm going to tighten it back down with my wrench here. Now, this is kind of the point I was getting at with not using the tools that you have sitting on your workbench. If you were in the field, if you're out camping, and you had to perform any sort of maintenance on your stove, now let's say I took a crescent wrench and I tightened that down, you know, a big crescent wrench. And I got that bolt really tight, so tight to the point where I could not loosen it with this. You only want to tighten things up so far to where this is all you need. If you know, you're out hiking, this is probably the only tool you're going to have. You may have a multi-tool, but you know, I don't know anyone that carries crescent wrenches or channel locks or anything like that with them in the woods. So you only want your bolts to be as tight as they would be if you were using this. So I try to stick with this when I'm performing my maintenance. Okay, so there's one here. Down here is there we go. Let the camera focus. That little white dot that I showed you I had in my hand. This guy right here. That's it. I'm trying to focus so you can see it. But that's where that goes. That's just for the fuel. Okay. So this is taken care of. Next, we're going to make sure that the jet is clean. Now, dragonflies do have what they call a shaker jet in them. And I'll show you what that is in a minute. But essentially, we're just going to... Well, I don't even have to close this up, I guess. You hear that noise? That's actually a jet inside there, jumping up and down. And what it's doing, it's pushing a pin through the head. You're probably not going to be able to see this on camera, but there's a itty-bitty hole in the dead center of this. Yeah, you're not going to be able to see it. But there's a little pin that pushes up through that when you shake it. And that's really all you need to do to clean your stove when it's in the field. Now, I am going to use a tool right now. In the directions that comes with your packet, it shows them using this tool to remove this. But it really is a pain in the neck, so I'm not even going to bother with it. So this is kind of like my one little exception to the rule. But in a pinch, this you really could use that tool with. It's just kind of a pain in the butt. Now this here, I said I bought this used. When I bought this, the jet was so tight in there that I could not get it out. I had to let, I think I used like a gun oil, you know, something equivalent to WD-40. And I just let it soak in there for like 2 days. And then I had to put a long-handled screwdriver and then like a crescent wrench or something and pry it. It was really tough. But now it's loose and I try to only go as tight as I can go with this. See, there we go, easy. And that's how it should be. Because, like I said, if you got to get in there, if you're out in the woods and you have to get into this, it has to be accessible with the tools that you have on you. Okay, so here's our jet. And you can see it's not nearly as nice as the other one. Obviously, the other one's never been used. But this does have rust on it. Okay, I don't know if you can see that. I'll try to show you. But that little thing laying in there, that is the shaker. Okay, it just sits in that hole in the bottom, and that's it. This is brassers, so there is weight to it, and that little needle is just big enough to pierce the hole in your jet. See how that fits right in there? And I can see it sticking out the top. So that's what you're doing when you shake it. You hear this piece of metal moving back and forth, and you hear it slapping into this. So earlier what I did was I just took a tool like this, and I went down there and kind of scraped anything out that I could find. Basically what's happening is it's starting to rust in there. I don't know why. I don't know if it's that happened since I've had it or if it was like that when I got it. But it is starting to rust up. You may be able to send that to MSR, and they may clean it for you, you know, remove all the deposits of rust, but I don't know. I know I did contact them once before in regards to the pump, and they would take care of it for me. Actually, I called them about this, and they told me to send it into them, and they would remove it for me, because I was really, like, convinced that there was no way I was going to be able to get that out. Now, MSR does sell a titanium spork, and I want to say, yep, right here in this picture right here, it actually shows them using it. So to get more leverage, you would thread the spork, spoon, whatever, through this tool and then use it as leverage to spin. So that's one of the benefits of buying the MSR spork. Yeah, that's all the little tools they show you, and they do give you a breakdown of the tool itself, and they show you how to use it and what parts of the stove it works best on. So okay, so that's the inside. Now, you know, guys, I'm not a professional. If I miss a step, I missed it because I didn't know. So if, you know, if someone out there knows something I don't, please inform me. I'm not above learning something new. But yeah, a pair of pliers really comes in handy when you get to this point. See, I got it on there crooked. There we go. And if it feels a little bit too loose, like that actually feels a little loose to me, I can probably just use my fingers and just give a little bit of a bend. And that there should get it good and tight. Hopefully I can get it back on. That doesn't seem right. Doesn't seem to want to line up. I don't know why. They should all be even. I don't think one is longer than the other. But, you know, this is maybe something that you kind of bump into as well when you're doing your maintenance. Okay, so it did snap in, and that's fine. You're going to get a little bit dirty. Yeah, no big deal. Okay, so this is good and clean. We lubed the rings down here. We cleaned out our jet. We made sure our shaker jet was clean from debris. I think this here is ready to go now.